Have you guys ever been so down bad after losing a ranked game that you decide to climb up a mountain just to take all your frustrations out on a tree? No. Yeah, me too, man. So unlike you and I, this menace is about to do the unthinkable after getting destroyed in his placement matches, so he decides to clap a tree to avenge his pride. However, the crazy thing is, our boy Lee Sien actually ends up finding a tree looking like Shakira, as its hips ain't lying. And just like we all expected, our boy whips out some foam to slip inside the tree, since it would be too dangerous to get any splinters on something as big as a person's battering ram. What's even crazier is the fact that the tree's opening coincides with what looks like the real deal, as if this entire thing is either alive or a perfect tree sculpted by a master artist on Pinterest. Regardless, right before Lee decides to get the super sussy show on the road, he realizes it's hard to get the banana plantation up and running when it's super cold on top of a mountain. So he decides to pop in some AirPods to listen in on westernized pieces of sussy culture. So now with him listening to a white woman and a black man doing some rice cake destroying, he decides to cosplay Old Man Skrillex as he starts going bangarang. After the beat drops, our boy goes even crazier than normal as he begins using his hands to channel his inner tens, allowing him to jet dash forward past the point of no return as his dash is stuck on cooldown. Moments later, he takes a page out of Sword Art Online as Lee starts dreaming of using augmented reality to destroy even more trees without him leaving his house, so it's super clear our boy has nothing wrong with him at all. He just happens to be a Chad gamer in love with Roblox, Minecraft, and Valorant, so he just needs a moment to relax from time to time whenever he gets pummeled by those younger and better looking than him, as nothing else beats seeding up a tree. After finishing his epic roleplay event from Goldshire in World of Warcraft, it dawned on Lee that he actually went through and let his intrusive thoughts win, as what kind of person would go toe to toe with a tree even if it looks like a person? But at least our boy is a nice guy as he cleans up after himself, but after taking a look at his fill-up bag, it looks like our boy has finally released all of his pent-up anger from his red carpet of losses in his match history. Nonetheless, as Lee leaves to go home to go back to his Radiant and Challenger grind, the tree begins to look like it's seeping some water from the very place Lee attacked with all his might. Shortly after, the tree began squirming, fully armed with pink hearts all around it. So maybe this is all just a sussy dream. Unfortunately, it wasn't, so upon arriving back home, Lee found a midget looking like some kind of elf from another world screaming and yelling at him for no reason. The midget girl then started to command our boy to take responsibility, but she's just met with a confused and profound face from Lee, as our boy is starting to think he exploded too hard, causing him to lose track of reality. Eventually, Lee found out that the elf wasn't wasting time screwing around, as she ended up removing his entire room and placed a bottomless pit for him to step into, if he decided to not cooperate. Our boy then learns from the elf-like being that he violated the number one rule in all of anime, and it's to never ring a ding a tree like a psychopath, since it could be someone's mom from another world. Now that Lee has discovered the tree he specifically chose tonight was somehow someone's mom, he starts yelling and hitting himself as he can't believe this is happening to him right now. Suddenly, the girl smirks, causing a bright purple flash to fully engulf our boy, so Lee loses track of his movement as everything around him begins to turn faster than his pronouns. Shortly after, the world stopped spinning around, he started losing consciousness as he watched himself fall into some kind of world. Upon waking up in another world dimension, he is greeted by a game-like system congratulating him for becoming the first ever husband candidate of the stupid single tree. After making sure he isn't dreaming, he realizes he screwed up as he doesn't want to be covered by King Anime Recaps as the one boy who destroyed a tree, causing him to be reincarnated in another world. It's then revealed that there's multiple world trees around the universe and their sole purpose is to protect and nurture the planet using their roots. Unfortunately for Lee, he ended up making contact with a young world tree wanting to make Earth its home, since Earth did not have a world tree to protect and nurture it. So the problem here is that our boy smashed the only tree willing to make Earth its home, so yeah, our boy screwed up bad. After pausing a moment to take all the information in, our boy starts maniacally laughing as he starts to think he can finally be the main character in his life, and it's all thanks to a random tree he found on a mountain. But then, out of nowhere, he slaps himself to stop laughing. So now having scared that our boy is exhibiting some extra hidden different personalities, exactly like in the movie Split. Regardless, he starts yelling at himself, wondering how he could laugh at such a dire time like this, as he needs to get out ASAP due to his clan on Clash of Clans needing him to 3-star the last base. As he weeps knowing that his clan will kick him out after missing his war attacks, a notification interrupts his sadness claiming that the World Tree of Purity is super shy. After a while, he gets super agitated that a notification keeps popping up as the World Tree of Purity is using the game system to talk to him like some kind of AI. Eventually, he hits enough of the world tree communicating with him, so he starts attacking the system modifications to the best of his abilities, whilst commanding her to bring him back to his original world. Unfortunately for Lee, the world tree claps back by refusing to send him back to Earth. Instead, she gives him a quest to make sure he's worthy of being a husband candidate, and if he fails to complete it, she warns him the penalty will be death. Upon hearing her last words, our boy decides to play ball like a true wimp, so he decides to ask what exactly must he do to complete his quest. And within a blink of an eye, Lee finds himself washing ashore an island with a humongous sandcastle before him, mysteriously named the Academy. His task is now to go inside and graduate within 120 days or else he will be fed to the neighboring tribal chieftain and turned into a very mystical and yummy soup. But if our boy is actually able to complete the mission, he will gain the quest reward of the World Tree's Sussy Love, while also having the added benefit of being able to live on. However, we discover he wasn't actually teleported to a deserted island, but it was actually just Lee dreaming about what's about to happen to him if he fails the mission. So he snaps back to reality and begins researching the new world he's in. He then finds out that the brand new world he got teleported to is basically Earth combined with some fantasy game elements, so there's a bunch of dungeons and everyone literally looks human. Nevertheless, the world tree interrupts him again and forces him to create his character in the brand new world, as all of his stats will reflect what he looks like on the planet. As such, our boy gets super excited at the thought of allocating all his skill points, since on Earth, all he did was game and nothing else, so at least he has some gaming expertise to help guide him through. But then it turns out he must be an iron player, as Bro decides to sacrifice all of his charm points so he could put more points into luck, causing the world tree to start weeping and shaking her head furiously. Against the world tree's wishes, Lee confirms his new abilities by punching the confirmation button, causing a blinding light to shine through the sky and straight into his body. He then starts getting infused with an otherworldly power, as lightning begins to surge through his entire body and out into the surroundings. After being infused with lightning and the traces finally going away, he begins feeling exhausted as he starts panting like he's totally out of breath, while also feeling super heavy, exactly like if he transformed into Nico Avocado. Nonetheless, he turns back towards the world tree only to find her absolutely sobbing about his new look, as Lee hasn't yet realized everyone else on the planet is only able to see his super ugly and overweight brand new version of himself. This doesn't bother our Chad though, so he tells the world tree not to worry, as he can just work out every day starting from tomorrow to lose all the weight he's apparently gained, as he has 120 days before the husbando exams. However, on his 13th day of constantly working out in the brand new world he lives in, he starts breaking down as he's making no progress losing some fat, so he's basically like the artist being too lazy to draw an overweight version of himself. But he knows he can't give up now as he wants to go back to the real world to watch his beloved Lakers win the championship again, so he's able to hype himself back up. As he continues his jog through a nearby university, he passes by two girls whom he overhears making fun of his appearance, claiming that he's even uglier than the troll ogre from Dark and Darker. As such, Lee gets riled so much that he actually turns into an ugly monkey instead. This causes him to finally lash out and start yelling at the girls, and he even goes as far as to chase them down as we find out our boy has some anger management issues. But then, as he chases after the girls that were busy making fun of him earlier, all of his commotion and loudness alert a nearby goddess busy quenching their thirst with some Mountain Dew. Then turns out that the girl is not only beautiful, but she got some massive pyramids of Giza, and she even managed to stick an entire oven below the ship's deck that could rival Nicki Minaj. Unluckily for our boy though, she stops to look only for her to start profusely sweating at the sight of seeing the ugliest man alive. Meanwhile, back to the action, our boy is too slow and he doesn't have enough stamina to continue chasing, so he ends up picking up a rock like a true monkey, threatening them that they shouldn't make fun of ugly people, as there's nothing wrong with having low charm. Luckily, a security officer is able to apprehend our boy before he got even more rowdy, so she tells him that being loud in public spaces is strictly prohibited. As such, she warns Lee that this is the last warning she will ever give him again, so we discover that he's actually been caught doing the same thing at least 6 times in the past week. And so our boy apologizes and promises to never step foot on the park again, but the lady lets him go as she feels some pity for Lee as life handed him a straight 0 out 10 on the attractiveness scale. But as soon as he leaves the premises of the park, some girl walks by him and starts insulting him by calling him a dinosaur, so our boy has to try his hardest to calm down. Regardless, he decides it's time to finally amp up his workouts as he can't even call it working out if all he does is jog around without lifting any weights. But then, just as he finishes signing up, he gets instantly rejected as the guy refuses him membership for being so unattractive that Lee has already broken the rule of never ever being disgusting or disrespectful towards other gym members. Our boy then attempts to plead for his case, telling the man he's not violating anything as he's not that ugly, but the guy claps back by handing him a mirror. Upon looking into the mirror, he transforms into Snow White, so the mirror actually instantly breaks just at the sheer sight of Lee's face, even though he can't actually see what he looks like as he can only see his previous self. Nonetheless, he heads back home, only to find himself being followed by numerous TV stations, as he becomes the hot topic of the planet for being the man who broke a mirror with his face.